Our help is in the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Good morning.
Good morning.
Today we celebrate the 22nd Sunday of Ordinary Time. And let us begin in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Lord, bless us with the wisdom to praise you in spirit and in truth, so that by following your holy will we may gain eternal salvation. Amen. My dear brothers and sisters, let us take a moment, confess our sins to God in ways that we have failed him and our neighbor in thought, word, deed, and omission, so that we may worthily participate in this holy sacrifice. Please now make an examination of your conscience. Let us say together the second form of the Confiteor found on page 66. I confess to Almighty God, in the presence of the Blessed Virgin Mary, all the saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, that I have sinned through my own fault, in my thoughts, in my words, in what I have done or failed to do. I ask the Blessed Virgin Mary, all the saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. For your penance, I would ask you to do an act of kindness for someone else sometime in the next couple of days. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And may our Lord Jesus Christ absolve you, and with his authority vested in me, I absolve you from all of your sins, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The law of the Lord is perfect, refreshing the soul. The decree of the Lord is trustworthy, giving wisdom to the simple. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth. Lord God, heavenly King, almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, your Son taught us that our inward disposition is far more important than our outward behavior alone. Help us to submit to all your precepts, not grudgingly out of necessity, but because we acknowledge your love for us. We ask this through the same Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated for our first reading.
A reading from the book of Deuteronomy. Moses said to the people, "Now, Israel, hear the statutes and decrees which I am teaching you to observe, that you may live and may enter in and take possession of the land which the Lord, the God of your fathers, is giving you. In your observance of the commandments of the Lord, your God, which I enjoin upon you, you shall not add to what I command you, nor subtract from it. Observe them carefully, for thus will you give evidence of your wisdom and intelligence to the nations, who will hear of all these statutes and say, 'This great nation is truly a wise and intelligent people.' For what great nation is there that has gods so close to it as the Lord our God is to us whenever we call upon him? Or what great nation has statutes and decrees that are as just as this whole law which I am setting before you today?" This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our response is, the one who does justice will live in the presence of the Lord. Whoever walks blamelessly and does justice, who thinks the truth in his heart and slanders not with his tongue.
Who does justice will live in the presence of the Lord.
Who harms not his fellow man, nor takes up a reproach against his neighbor, by whom the reprobate is despised, while he honors those who fear the Lord. Who lends not his money at usury and accepts no bribe against the innocent. Whoever does these things shall never be disturbed. A reading from the letter of St. James. Dearest brothers and sisters, all good giving and every perfect gift is from above, coming down from the Father of lights, with whom there is no alteration or shadow caused by change. He willed to give us birth by the word of truth, that we may be a kind of first fruits of his creatures. Humbly welcome the word that has been planted in you and is able to save your souls. Be doers of the word and not hearers only, deluding yourselves. Religion that is pure and undefiled before God and the Father is this: to care for orphans and widows in their affliction, and to keep oneself unstained by the world. This is the word of the Lord.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia. The Father willed to give us birth by the word of truth, that we may be a kind of first fruits of his creatures.
Alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Mark. When the Pharisees with some scribes who had come from Jerusalem gathered around Jesus, they observed that some of his disciples ate their meals with unclean, that is, unwashed hands. For the Pharisees, and in fact all Jews, do not eat without carefully washing their hands, keeping the tradition of the elders. And on coming from the marketplace, they do not eat without purifying themselves. And there are many other things that they have traditionally observed: the purification of cups and jugs and kettles and beds. So the Pharisees and scribes questioned him, "Why do your disciples not follow the tradition of the elders, but instead eat a meal with unclean hands?" He responded, Well did Isaiah prophesy about you hypocrites, as it is written, this people honors me with their lips, but their hearts are far from me. In vain do they worship me, teaching as doctrines human precepts. You disregard God's commandment, but cling to human tradition. He summoned the crowd again and said to them, hear me, all of you, and understand. Nothing that enters one from the outside can defile that person, but the things that come out from within are what defile. From within people, from their hearts, come evil thoughts, unchastity, theft, murder, adultery, greed, malice, deceit, licentiousness, envy, blasphemy, arrogance, folly. All these evils come from within, and they defile. This is the gospel of the Lord. This people honors me with their lips, but their hearts are far from me. In vain do they worship me, teaching as doctrines human precepts. These words are taken from today's gospel according to St. Mark, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, of the Holy Spirit. Amen. My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, all of us, I think, are familiar with rituals. In fact, I dare say probably most of us have our own rituals. Most likely in the morning, like myself, where I get up, feed the dogs, put on the coffee, take them out, take my pills, come in, take my pills. And if we don't start our ritual and keep it going through the end, we sometimes feel off, somewhat like myself this morning, having forgotten one of my parts, and I'm really feeling it right now. But rituals, while important, can keep us focused. The ritual itself cannot be our reason for living. Now, if I lived just to wake up, take out the dogs, put on the coffee, and so forth, what kind of life would that be? And what Jesus is talking about in today's gospel is the fact that these rituals that came to pass from the Mosaic Law. Now, firstly, the Mosaic Law only said that we should clean ourselves before we eat. It was later human tradition that the rabbis over time put in place that came in with all of these onerous, involved cleansing rituals that then became more important than the meaning behind it. And that's what Jesus is talking about. So when the scribes and Pharisees come in and criticize Jesus and his disciples for not purifying themselves in the ritual way, they're talking about following the human rituals that were set up and have been and were followed for upward of 2,000 years at that point. So Jesus wants to refocus them like he wants to refocus us. He's not talking about doing away with rituals, but he's talking about focusing on the important parts. We do a ritual every time we come to Mass. The Mass is ritualistic. We do the same thing, the same way, each and every time. There's a couple reasons for that, and we need to keep in mind that it's not just going through the motions. What we do at every Mass is we transcend time and place back to the Last Supper. We are transported. It is not the priest that's there
during the consecration. It's Jesus himself. I leave, he comes for that time. And that, if we keep that in mind, how miraculous is that? How utterly mind-blowing is that? That Jesus comes to us to give us his body and his blood, that we receive not just a piece of bread and a little bit of wine, but his literal self that becomes a part of us and changes us. Now, just as he says, nothing that enters one from the outside can defile that person. It comes from the inside. So if we take him into us, he will change us. And those things that he mentions, evil thoughts, unchastity, theft, murder, so on and so forth, the vices that he talks about, we can change into virtues if we find them in us and work on them. We talked about vices and virtues a few weeks ago. And if we keep that in mind, that if we self-reflect on a regular basis and we find any of these things inside us, we can work on switching them, changing our habitus, our habits, to make, say, envy something into generosity and so forth. So perhaps as we go through our holiday weekend, we maybe can take a little bit of time to ourselves and look really deeply at ourselves and those things that we may find there that we don't like, and utilize prayer and the sacraments and self-control and all the fruits and gifts of the Spirit to help us change those things into virtues that not only will then change us for the better, but will emanate out from us so we can help change our friends, our family, our world for the better. Isn't that really why we're here in the first place? To worship God and become more like him and spread that into the world? This people honors me with their lips, but their hearts are far from me. In vain do they worship me, teaching his doctrines, human precepts. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Let us now stand and turn to page 71 and say together the creed that unites us as Christians. I believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven by the power of the Holy Spirit. He was born of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in fulfillment of the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord and giver of life, who proceeds from the Father. With the Father and the Son, he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. The Lord be with you. Having heard the word of God, let us act upon it by seeking in prayer the gifts God has promised. And our response is, Lord, hear our prayer. For the church, that we may experience an ever deeper conversion of mind and heart as we allow God's word to instruct and free us, we pray to the Lord. That the Spirit will renew the dedication of those working for peace and help all to work together to defeat the common enemies of disease, ignorance, abortion, euthanasia, and poverty. We pray to the Lord. That peace and reconstruction become realities in Ukraine, the Middle East, and every tortured land, and that our armed forces are protected. We pray to the Lord. For all who are suffering in body, mind, or spirit, those and those on our parish prayer list, that they may be healed by Christ, the great physician, we pray to the Lord. For our own needs and intentions, we hold deep in the silence of our hearts. And for whom this Mass is being offered, which is for all of those who lost their lives in the 20th century labor movements, we pray to the Lord. For all of those who have died, and those who will die today, that they may rest in the peace of our Lord, we pray to the Lord. Father, we ask you to hear and answer all these prayers, both spoken and unspoken, and those which remain within our hearts. We ask all these things to your Son, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
The fear of the Lord is pure, enduring forever. The ordinances of the Lord are sure and altogether righteous. Blessed are you, Lord God, of all creation, through this has bread offered, which is given here and hence may become for us the bread of life. But the mystery of this wine, water, may we come to share in the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord God, of all creation, who gives us wine to offer fruit of thy work, whose hands may become our spiritual drink. Lord God, we ask you to receive us and be pleased with the sacrifice we offer you with humble and contrite hearts. Come, Holy Spirit, and bless the sacrifice which you prepared for the glory of your holy name. Lord, wash away my iniquity. Cleanse me from my sin. See this offering of the Holy Trinity, which the passion, resurrection, such of the Lord Jesus Christ, and all of us, all sins, and days, and on earth, proceed for us in heaven. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Gracious Father, as we present these gifts before you, we ask that whenever we struggle with the evil about us, whenever human traditions obscure your will, draw us to a more zealous obedience. We ask this in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. Father, all-powerful and ever-living God, we do well always and everywhere to give you thanks through your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. Through his teaching and ministry, Jesus showed us how we are to live, giving our lives in service to you and all people. Still hearing his word in our world today, we strive to follow his example and set our hearts on the world to come. Therefore, with the angels and archangels, with all the saints and the entire church, we lift our hymn of praise to your glory, repeating unceasingly, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. The Holy Sacrifice of the Mass continues with Eucharistic Prayer 5, which is found on page 92. Blessed are you, God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, Father of mercy and God of all consolation. For you so loved the world that you gave your only begotten Son, that whoever believes in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. He then established a lasting memorial of your salvation. On the evening in which he willingly surrendered himself, he took bread, gave you thanks, blessed it and broke it, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat it, for this is my body, which is given for you." When supper had ended, he took the cup in the same way he gave you thanks and blessed it, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the cup of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant, which shall be shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. As often as you do this, do it in remembrance of me." So we recall before you, Father, the incarnation of your Son, his words and deeds, how he humbled himself and obediently accepted death, even death on the cross. Therefore you have raised him up and given him a name which is above every name, so that in heaven and under the earth every knee shall bow and every tongue proclaim to the glory of God the Father, Jesus Christ is Lord. We offer the sacrifice of your Son before you, Father, with praise and thanksgiving, and ask that you accept this oblation. Send your Holy Spirit and fill these gifts with his life-giving power, that they may be for us the body and blood of your dearly beloved Son. Grant that the bread which we break may be the body of our Lord, and the cup over which we give thanks may be one with the blood of our Lord, Jesus Christ. In the company of Mary, the Mother of God, with your apostles and martyrs, with Holy Willibrord and all the saints, together with Anthony, our prime bishop, Charles, our administrator, and with all bishops, priests and deacons, as well as your whole church, we praise and glorify you and look forward to the coming of your beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ.
Through him, with him, in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory are yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever. Amen.
Page 95, let's pray together with confidence to the Father in the words our Savior taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin and protect us from all anxiety as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. The cup of blessing which we bless, is it not a participation in the blood of Christ? The bread which we break, is it not a participation in the body of Christ? May the union of divinity and humanity in Jesus Christ bring us sanctification and eternal life. Amen. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "I leave you peace. My peace I give you. Do not look at our sins, but on the faith of your church. And grant us the peace and unity of your kingdom where you live forever and ever." Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let's offer each other a sign of peace, a happy Hog Days, and a happy Labor Day. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Let us say together the Second Communion prayer found on page 98 of the pew book. May the partaking of your body and blood, Lord Jesus, not be cause for my judgment or condemnation, though I am unworthy to receive this great sacrament, through your loving kindness, may it become my safeguard and healing remedy. My saving Master, awaken in me a living faith, fervent love, worship, adoration, and a holy longing. Through this communion, make me your willing servant, zealous to fulfill your holy will. May it at last unite me entirely with you, my Lord and my God. I will take the bread of heaven and call upon the name of the Lord. Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word and I shall be healed. May the body of Christ bring me to everlasting life. May the blood of Christ bring me to everlasting life. For those who are joining us online or who for personal reasons cannot receive the body and blood of Christ today, please join me now in the act of spiritual communion. Most loving Jesus, I adore you in the most blessed sacrament in which you are truly present. I love you above all things, and I long for you in my soul. Since I cannot receive you sacramentally, I ask you to come spiritually into my heart and heal my soul. I embrace you and unite myself with you. May I never be separated from you. Inflame my heart by the fire of your love. My Lord and Savior, amen. This is the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are those who are called to the table of the Lord. The body and blood of Christ. The body and blood of Christ. The body and blood of Christ. Body and blood of Christ. The 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 body and blood of Christ. Body and blood of Christ. The body and blood of Christ. The body of Christ. The body and blood of Christ. The body and blood of Christ. And blood of Christ.
Insecurity. I've been pretending to be the person everybody wants me to be. I can't go on living a lie when I know I'm broken on the inside. God, you're strong when I am weak. I need your grace to help me see that I'm no longer. Set free, you make me clean.
need your grace to help me see. I'm no longer a slave to me. I've been washed, I've been set free. You make me clean.
See to it that no one captivate you with an empty, seductive philosophy according to human tradition, according to the elemental powers of the world, and not according to Christ. Let us pray. Almighty God, by the grace of this Holy Communion, recreate us in the image of your Son, so that we, putting aside all human vanities, may receive his word, which alone can save us. We ask this through the same Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
May the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come upon you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please join me now in the prayer of St. Michael. Holy Michael, the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our safeguard against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And to you, O Prince of the Heavenly Host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who wander through the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen. Please join me now in a prayer for peace with the prayer of St. Francis. Lord, make me an instrument of your peace. Where there is hatred, let me sow love. Where there is injury, pardon. Where there is doubt, faith. Where there is despair, hope. Where there is darkness, light. And where there is sadness, joy. O Divine Master, grant that we may not so much seek to be consoled as to console, to be understood as to understand, to be loved as to love. For it is in giving that we receive. It is in pardoning that we are pardoned. It is in dying that we are born to eternal life. Amen. My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, thank you so much for joining us for Holy Mass today. We pray that you have a wonderful day, weekend, holiday. Take care of yourselves. Take care of each other. Remain in the state of grace. Fight evil wherever you find it. Spread joy and the word of God wherever you go.